In this tutorial, we learn about residuals. So residuals are just the difference between the experimental data and the predicted data by the curve fitting function. So here we have temperature variation with respect to time, and I've plotted this data using a scatter plot. Now let's say we want to add a straight line fit to the data. So select the chart, click on the plus sign, then click on the sideways arrow next to trend line and choose more options. So the linear curve fit is selected by default. Now let's display the equation on chart and the R square value. So we can format it, go to the format tab, add a white shape fill and a black shape outline. So if you look at the coefficient of determination, you can see that it is very close to one. And at the first glance, you can say that this straight line is a good fit to the data. However, let's see what happens when you plot the residuals variation with respect to time. Now, in order to obtain the residuals, we need to calculate the predicted temperature by the straight line equation. So select cell C5. So this is equal to the slope, which is 2.7455 times X. Select cell A5, and X here is the time, plus 296.35, and hit Ctrl Enter and double click to autofill. Now the residuals are just the difference between experimental temperature and the predicted temperature. So it is equal B5 minus C5, Ctrl Enter and double click to autofill. Now let's create the residuals plot. So select the residuals data, hold on the Ctrl key, then select the time data. Go to the Insert tab, to the chart section, and insert the scatter. So we will have now the residuals plot. So if your residuals are obtained from normal experimental errors, then they should be randomly distributed below and above the x equal to zero line. However, if your residuals have an observable trend or a pattern, then you should question your fit, as in this example. So if you look at the residuals, they have a parabolic distribution around x equal to zero, or what we call a U-shaped distribution around x equal to zero. So in order to have a good residual plot, they should be randomly distributed above or below x equal to zero. So in other words, if you obtain an observable trend in the residuals plot, then you should maybe consider using another fitting function. Now let's plot the residuals when using a polynomial fit to the data. So we select this chart, for example, click on the plus sign, then click on the sideways arrow, choose more options. Then go to trend line options and choose a polynomial fit. Display the equation and the R square value. Now let's add a white shape fill and a black shape outline. Now let's calculate the predicted temperature by this polynomial function. So select cell C18 equal to 0.1136 into X squared into T squared, or A18 squared, plus 1.7227 times X, plus 297.71. Then hit Ctrl Enter and double click to autofill. Now the residuals are just the difference between B18 and C18. Let's plot the residuals. Select these two columns, go to the Insert tab and insert Y scatter. Now, if you look at the residuals here, they are randomly distributed above and below X equal to zero, and they don't have some observable trend variation like in the residuals plot when we've used the linear function. So when assessing your fit, in conclusion, you should not just look at the R square value if it is close to one. You should also look at your residuals plot and make sure that your residuals are randomly distributed around x equal to 0.